A big question on almost everyone's mind this week. Are Memphis police trying to spy on you or just trying to keep you safe? Police say a court-ordered decree from 40 years ago is hurting their efforts to fight crime. But supporters of the bill say the decree is simply protecting your rights. That decree from the late 70s limits the power of police investigations, but the decree doesn't take into consideration modern technology. So, Matt, crime fighters will say, you know, this is good police work, and opponents will tell you, no, they're just spying on us. Which is it?
Well, I mean, this consent decree happened before I was born. I mean, it really is. They're not taking in consideration the social media presence that law enforcement now uses to not spy on people. We were just talking about juvenile crime a little while ago. Well, one of the things that we do to combat all kinds of crime is we try to monitor things on Facebook and social media. And we were supposed to be doing that for Homeland Security. So I think there has to be some kind of common sense in this. I know the monitor, Ed Stanton, who's doing this, I believe they're starting to think that there are some issues that law enforcement, the consent decree from, 1968 goes a little bit too far.
1978.
Yeah, or 1978. So I was born. I'll say that. But the consent decree probably goes a little bit too far, and I think we have some tweaking to do on this to give the officers some room to maneuver.
Commissioner, what do you think? Does the decree stop police from doing their jobs, or would it help them to do their jobs?
I don't think it does. I mean, I agree with what Matt said. It's Facebook. I mean, it's the internet. There's all kinds of, you know, people all over the internet, and in order for the police to, you know, quote unquote, infiltrate some of these groups, the groups actually have to friend them and approve their entrance into the group. So a lot of this just, I think it's getting a little bit taken too far with the consent decree.
If the decree is lifted, would that give Big Brother too much power, too much authority?
No,
what do you think?
It's not gonna, they're doing it anyway.
Yeah.
They're doing it anyway, honey. They're doing it. They're doing it. That's all.
Well, at what point would this become an abuse of power, do you think?
Well, I don't think it's an abuse of power. I think when you look at the social media and you see a young man holding up a gun and got hundreds of dollars, you know something is going on. So, you know, I think there's no abuse of power right there with our social media, none at all.
Where do you think this goes from here, Matt?
Well, let me give you an example of one of the things. If MPD, through monitoring of social media, and the social media is from a political group, and that political group on their social media, the MPD finds something that says that they're going to blow up the Memphis, Arkansas bridge.
Exactly.
They couldn't use it. They are prohibited by this consent decree from acting on that information. And that's the kind of thing
they wouldn't even be able to look at that.
Well, exactly.
Right. So it's not that they wouldn't know it. They wouldn't even have any knowledge of it.
Right.
What about the consideration that some opponents say this is creating a blacklist for many people within the city, and they're being targeted unfairly?
Well, there was a blacklist, of course, with the city hall, because every time you came through the door, they saw who you were, and so they prevented you from coming in there. Some of those things will have to stop, but I think for the most part, we have to get the police the things that they want in order to get the things that we need. Exactly.
Yeah, I agree. Yeah. I mean, I think the police need the ability to watch people, and if you're asked to have an escort when you walk through, you know, City Hall, I don't have an issue with that either. I mean, there's plenty of businesses around town that do the exact same thing. When guests come into the office, they have an escort, and even if the police are not escorting you around the building, I could guarantee all the security cameras in City Hall are sitting there watching you as well. So
yes.
Whether you have an escort or not, you're going to be watched.
Matt, are you worried at all that if this decree were lifted, that police would abuse this in any way?
Oh, not in the least, and I am concerned, and government officials, mayors, police departments, they have an obligation to follow the law. And if you are spying on someone and using intelligence for a political gain or something, that's obviously against your First Amendment right, and that person would have a case against that. I think that goes too far.
What do you think about the mayor stepping in the middle of this fray? Saying that it needed to be lifted.
Yeah, I think he's right. I think it does need to be lifted, and I would stand by the. I think we're putting handcuffs on our police to keep us safe by not lifting it.
And they're not doing what they did in 1968 when they logged in on my phone calls when I was only 18 years old. So,
right.
Yeah. So
a little different now.
Yeah, oh,
yes.
Much differently. All
right.
Yeah.
All right. We will have some final thoughts when we come back on Informed Sources. Stay with us.